Mom, I... Huh? Mom, hello? Mom! Where am I? What is this place? What am I doing here? Oh, Lester, it seems bad luck is chasing you. First the news about moving to the Boston poorhouse, and now this. Wait, I remember something.
Hello there, child. Where are you going this fine evening?
I'm just on my way back from school.
Oh, really? I don't think so.
No, wait! Let go! Where are you taking me?
Buckle up, kid. We're in for a long ride through the woods, and then a walk. Even the horses daren't tread that far.
Who was that man? Why did he bring me here? I don't know this place. I just want to be at home with Mom. I need to get out of here. A matchbox.
Dearest son, in the darkest hours of our lives, I just want to remind you of how much I love you. I know these are hard times for us, and I'm working at the inn as much as I can so that I can provide you with the best possible education. But I know it is not enough to give you the life that you deserve. Being abandoned by your own father even before you were born made things difficult. However, thanks to our love for each other, we will overcome any difficulty we may encounter in the future. Your loving...
key. Flashlight. A matchbox. I need something. I need something. A matchbox. A matchbox. A matchbox. I need something. A battery. I need something. I need something. A matchbox. Photograph. A magnifying glass. Something. Matchbox. A photograph.
Dear Reginald, there is not a single day here in Candlewood that we don't hear a gloomy story about the Caravan family. As your elder sister, I am very worried about your sanity in that house. It is not a matter of being pointed at by people that we do not care about. It is just that we're worried about you. I am sure that you could easily find a position as a butler in any of the wealthy families in Candlewood, so I strongly beg you to reconsider your decision and return to our family home. Please let me know your decision. Your elder sister, Prudence Wintergreen.
Knife. Great. Some keys. I need something. I need something.
Mr. Caravan, this is to confirm that the work has been successfully completed. As we agreed last week, we took this kid, Lester Barnard, away. We will keep him in our custody until next Friday at the Red Fox Inn. Following your orders, that day the kid will be delivered to your home by one of my men. Thank you again for trusting in our work. Sincerely, Albert Campbell.
need something. Some papers. A matchbox.
Mr. Caravan, this is to confirm that the work has been successfully...
Dear Reginald, there is not a... Miss Madeline, as you very well know, my son Lester is also the son of your husband, Arthur. I don't want to sound rude, but your husband is an abomination. Since he learned of my pregnancy, he has been trying to make our lives impossible. We are very poor, but at least we are a family full of love and not hate. So I beseech you to convince him to forever leave us alone. Lester is a Barnard and will never be a Caravan. I am sure you're with me on this. You too are a mother, so I really hope that you will understand my situation. Sincerely, Josephine Barnard.
I need something. a paper. I need something. A letter opener.
Mr. Caravan, following your instructions, last week we visited your property in order to assess its condition, and it is my responsibility to warn you that our findings will not be to your liking. The first impression of the house and its surroundings warn you of what is to come.
decayed trees and dead surroundings, capable of depressing even the most cheerful soul. The main feature of this mansion of gloom is its excessive antiquity, and the feeling of great melancholy and sorrow that arrives after staring at the house for even a moment. Bleak walls, vacant eye-like windows, and worst of all, a tiny crack tearing the house in two, like a cutting knife, but inevitably condemning the house to its end. Sincerely, James Rowling.
A photograph. A matchbox. Need something. A matchbox.
Dear Arthur, I would like to convey, on my behalf and that of my entire family, our deepest condolences for the death of your son, Arthur Jr. Since reading in the local newspapers of the news of the death of your poor child in a tragic hunting accident, my whole family is appalled. Of course, you can count on us for anything you need. All my heart, Eric Austin.
A matchbox. Photograph. I need something. I need something. I need something. Matchbox.
Dear Mr. Caravan, I would like to confess my concerns to you about the mental state of Lady Madeline following the death of Arthur Jr. In addition to my usual diagnosis of Lady Madeline, since the loss, I have found in her an unhealthy nervous agitation. We are speaking of a mental disorder which oppresses Lady Madeline, but to a lesser extent extends its grip on many of the caravans. I therefore feel obliged to recommend the immediate admission of Lady Madeline to Candlewood's mental hospital, in order to gain a more complete diagnosis and determine the best treatment that will lead to her recovery. Sincerely, Dr. Frank T. Kelly.
Prehistoric signs book. Thank you. perfect. A document. A matchbox. A wire. A matchbox. I need something.
Mr. Caravan, as you requested, we have created two new coffins for your family. We have also sculpted the names of Lady Madeline and your own on each plate. As our family has been making coffins for the Caravan family for generations, we know well that each member of the caravans orders his own coffin in advance. We hope that it is this reason, and not because any death is expected, that you have placed your order. As agreed, the coffins will be delivered to your house on Monday morning. We are looking forward to making more coffins for your family in the future. Sincerely, James Underwood.
Mr. Caravan, this is to confirm that following your orders, your request has been successfully completed. Since early this morning, the dead body of Josephine Barnard lays at the bottom of the Charles River, and I can assure you that the body will never be found. As you requested, she did not suffer any pain in the operation. Do not hesitate to contact us again for any other work you need from us in the future. Sincerely, Albert Campbell.
A hammer. A matchbox. A battery. Wire. A wire. Thank you. need something. A wire. I need something. Perfect.
This is to inform you that we have canceled our agreement with the house. We have been delivering supplies to the caravan house for the last 5 years. So far, we have no complaints about our relationship. However, our grocery store in Candlewood has been losing clients due to our trips to the house. You know that people are very superstitious, and they're afraid of these kinds of things. We hope that you will understand our situation. Sincerely, Edna Harrington.
need something. There we are. Some keys. I need something. I need something. I need something. Matchbox. matchbox.
Dear Mr. Caravan, as we agreed last week, everything is ready for the admission of Lady Madeline at the mental hospital. You have my word that she will receive the best medical care from our doctors and the best treatment techniques will be used. I remember you also told me the day we last met that your son Lester will be sent to the house the same day. So I just hope that everything will be alright in your family, as he will remain alone there until your return. I will be waiting for your arrival on the evening of Friday the 29th, and you can tell your coachman to leave the carriage at the hospital and return home the next day. Sincerely, Dr. Frank T. Kelly.
Matchbox.
Okay.